tuning their 15 voices into the 88 keys of the piano man himself. Last week, the Yellow Jackets came out swinging with their powerful message.
Nice.
But still found themselves in the bottom two, battling the collective on the show's very first sing-off. Sarah, looks like you're the tiebreaker.
I chose the group that I felt took the right risks. I chose the Yellow Jackets.
Sometimes we don't meet everyone's expectations, but looking up in the audience and knowing that our parents were there, that was that extra little bit of strength to make sure that we would get through to the next round.
This week, our superstar is Billy Joel, and we are honored to be able to do three of his songs.
In the middle of the night.
Just kind of hanging on last week, we never want to be in that position again. So this week, we really want to focus on incorporating the judges' comments into our performance.
What Sarah said was that she chose us because that song was a completely different style than what we have shown them in the past. So I think we got to continue rolling with that.
This week in our medley, we're having three very different songs. Uptown Girl, A River of Dreams, and She's Always a Woman. None of our songs have really been ballads yet, and I think that getting to do a ballad is gonna show that we're not always the goofy college kids that everybody might think that we are.
Throughout all the pressure, what continues to make this such an exciting process is all of our families. To look up and see our parents there and our friends, it just makes us tear up.
Look at their hopeful faces. We can't let them down. We're staying. Even if we're the underdog here, we're gonna stay.
Hopefully they can strike a chord with the judges, performing a superstar medley by Billy Joel. Here are the Yellow Jackets.
She's ahead of her time.
Yellow Jackets, taking us all uptown. How they do, Ben? What you think?
Yeah, great. The start was really great with River of Dreams. I think you brought in some of the African influence in a good way. And, oh, She's Always Woman employed a kind of percussion, vocal percussion, that I generally disapprove of, which is the use of percussive mouth cymbals. But it was really cool. It's like you brought the wind. So, Jordan, nice work. You brought the wind. I really like the transition into Uptown Girl, and again, that's Jordan. That was a nice little drum fill into it, and that was great. John, you sang your butt off. That was really pretty. You're all singing with loads of heart. It's all locked and everything. The only thing I ever worry about with you guys is that you have a group personality, and you've got really strong singers. We got to know who you lead singers are when we shut our eyes, and you're coming together more and more as a group in every musical way. You don't have a character voice, so you really have to lean on your personality as a whole. But I thought it was a really great arrangement. Nice work.
Sean, your thoughts?
You guys did show another side of you guys with the arrangement, especially with She's Always a Woman. Like, the way you guys broke it down and pianissimo'd the whole thing and just made it very sweet and just endearing and sincere. There's a different side of you that I've never seen. You know, Aaron. Hey, man. Again, nailing your lead, doing what you do, man. It was a little trouble holding that high note at the end, but you found it, and your guys helped you out to make it all, you know, come clean at the end. You know, John, you said taking on a ballad is going to be the challenge, and I think you guys did it well. You guys really showed another side to the YJs, and I dug it.
Sarah?
I heard the Yellow Jackets, too. I think you guys were great. I think that this was a really strong choice of a medley for you guys, and this was as well as I've heard you blend overall. I loved your lead vocalist. I loved Jamal. Oh my God, I just love you so much. And I would have gotten rid of the vocal percussion in the middle section.
Not the wind?
I wasn't a fan of the wind. Oh. I'm sorry. That was a choice. But that for me that was.
The wind.
It's creepy.
It is Halloween. I mean, a little creepy wind.
I think the challenge for you guys is harnessing some of that just raw energy that you have. You have such a family unit up here. It's so obvious. But I felt like by the end, you'd sort of overpowered Aaron a little bit. But well done, you guys. Well done.
Okay, judges. We'll find out in moments if the Yellow Jackets will stay in the hunt for the crown. Thanks, guys.